What's up, you guys? Happy Aries season. So we are going to get into a pick a card reading. So for Aries, I did do an individual reading for you. You can check that out on the previous video before this one. So for those of you who are new, welcome. For those of you who are returning, thank you so much. Thank you for being here. So as always, if you are seeking a personal anything, tarot reading, hypnotherapy session, any conjure work, root work, you can find everything in the link below. And we also have a spring equinox virtual retreat coming up on April the 1st to the 3rd, where we'll be having some rebirthing hypnosis, some Reiki, some guided and intuitive movement, along with psychic medium readings. So that's going to be a good time, a great time to come and rejuvenate and, you know, really get ready and be in this spring energy fully, all right? So yes, let's go ahead and get into this. So this is going to actually be a pick a card. So for the pick a card, you can choose from these three here. Okay, so first we have the mortar and pestle. Then we have the Himalayan salt heart rock. And then we have the moon globe. So take a moment if you need to pause the video, whatever works best for you, and choose which option you would like to go with today. And yes, let's get started. What is up, pile one? So this is for those who chose the mortal and pestle. So what I'm getting is there, in regards to that, there may be some grounding that needs to happen for you, possibly literally, or perhaps it's time to bring things together to work all into one cohesively. And, you know, being very intentional with the use of your time, the use of your energy, the use of your focus, all right, the use of your thought, your emotions, and how it is that that's playing its part in your life, right? In recognizing how it is that you're showing up within that as well. Like, are you being true to your nature in that regard, or is there something that's needing to be added, or is there something that's needing to be taken away? You know, there may be some needing to put muscle into the action it is that you're doing, right? This can even be you needing to connect a little bit more with consistently with your personal feminine energy, right? And recognizing where you have been off balance with that, with your ideas, and carrying that out, right? With the understanding you have and living through that, you know. So let's see how the cards have to say for you at this time. Spirit, ancestors, guides, angels that walk with us, I ask that you come through and offer your insight, guidance, and support. Or pile one in the messages it is that they need to hear at this time. What insight, what guidance do they need? Please allow me to be a conduit in providing the messages that they are, that will best serve them today, tomorrow, and moving forward through this Aries season. What does pile one need to hear right now? Okay, problem. All right, so this is very interesting. So we have the big queen, which is the empress, the ace of knives, Miss Ida, and who's the high priestess, and the four of knives. So it's almost, it's like these fate needs to come into play, destiny needs to come into play so that you can get out of an old pattern, Perhaps this has to do with a way of thought. Perhaps the grounding needs to happen within your mind, right? And support you within your actions. There may be some balance that's needed within your giving and receiving. You know, are you giving too much? Are you not giving enough? Are you taking more than what you're giving? Are you just embracing energies where you need to just kind of relax, right? But this is also focused on your physical reality. You know, how do you want that to feel? What do you want that to look like? What do you want to be part of that? Okay, this is also about your abundance and your ability to bring that in, draw that in. And perhaps there's a new way of thought that's needed in order for you to really connect with that, right? To see things clearly, finding clarity, having a better perspective, a stronger perspective on what it is that is true for you. Right, and a need to go within. There needs a pause that's needing to happen, like some time needs to be taken. Maybe you need to take 7 days, 7 weeks, 7 months, I don't know, 7 hours, you know. However, but there is a pause, a break that's needing to happen so that you can move forward in a way that is of peace, you know, that is not all over the place, right? Because then we have the Four of Knives. You know, this Four of Knives is coming in after Miss Ida, and both of those cards are about a break, a pause, a stop, you know, reflection, seeing what the Four of Knives is. Even like, I'm not thinking about nothing, I'm not feeling nothing, I'm just being, I'm just here, I'm taking a break. You know, and it's like there's been some strong conflict within, and perhaps that may be affecting your material world in some sense. Maybe this has to do with your material world, okay? This, maybe it has something to do with movement, perhaps, more so than anything, movement of the mind, though. Movement of perception, movement of how it is that you communicate. Perhaps that's been out of balance in a sense. There's been more communication going outward, where there needs to be only communication with yourself at this time. You know, so because this is a lot about getting grounded. The big queen, she's grounded. She's ruled by Venus. Okay, so this is about your beauty, this is about your health, this is about your pleasure, right? It's what you're doing. Does it feel good? When the thoughts that you think, do they make you feel good? You know, do you find joy in them? Do you have a way, the way your mind is processing, does it bring forth a future vision of celebration? Okay. So let's see, what other messages do you have here for Power and Spirit? What else would you like for them to know at this time? Something is definitely, it's a change, a shift in things. I know the weather has been kind of weird where I am. I'm in America. I don't know where you're watching this, but I'm also in the South. So the weather's been really crazy here. It's been tornado warnings and a lot of rain and thunderstorms, a lot of lightning. You know, and that's very strong Oya energy, and this air energy is representative of that for me as well. You know, and then with Miss Ida in the middle, it's like needing to tap into, that's High Priestess energy, right? So that is intuition, that's trust, that's faith, that's belief. That is knowing that everything lives within you. You have the Big Queen and Miss Ida here, so you... what I'm getting is you don't see, you may not be seeing yourself. Okay. Maybe you are not fully recognizing the power it is that you have, because the Bitcoin only comes because she was Miss Item, right? She did the work. She went through the initiation. She learned herself. She learned life. She connected herself to her channel to connect to spirit, to her ancestors. And then she manifests her reality by way of this, right? So it's like, in a sense, think highly of yourself. Because you know, rest on your laurels. You know this. What else is here? Aries season for power. Two comments. So we have, this is Melusina. She is a mermaid, number 17. She says, the calm of patience brings tranquility and sea. So you may be learning something, maybe something that, it may be like an awakening that's happening for you. It could be something shocking, perhaps because Melusina, she was the wife of Freud and she was a mermaid. He peeked into the bathroom while she was bathing. And when her fin tail was out, because she turns into a mermaid at the full moon. Okay, so after that, she left him and never returned because he broke his promise. And so this is one saying to me a need to really be comfortable with being yourself, right? There may be some awakening that's happening that you see that you have not been comfortable being that, right? And mermaids, they go deep. So this is something very deep within you that's needing to be acknowledged, it's needing to be embraced, you know, really connecting to the star of you, your star player. And I say that because the number 17, that is like the star card in the tarot, right? So that you can attain this Bitcoin energy if you're not already in it. If anything, part of me feels like you're already living it and you're not really seeing it clearly. Okay, so the second card is the Nyx. And it says, calm waters reflect clearer inner images than rough waters. And that's number 22. And so that is a lot about seeing things clearly, recognizing what the truth is, what is really real, okay? And taking time to, because Melusina talks about pausing before responding, right? And the Nyx speaks about versatility, okay? So, I'm sorry, she speaks about vigilance. So I'm gonna read her card. She says, the Nyx, a mill pond dweller that administers justice, advises caution and foresight because you may risk gaining one desire to the detriment of a superior plane. Her calm symbolizes reconciliation. Her flute inspires love and her golden spinning wheel represents the bringing forth of a new life for you. Love will have a happy ending, whether it is with one from who you are estranged with or with someone new. Financial wealth forecast for you or an invitation involving money may have a catch to it. Remember, what you gain you have, what you spent you had, what you had you lost. No one will drag you down. Follow your heart, aim high. Yeah, so that's what I was getting as well. This may have a lot to do with relationships within your life, right? And the communication within them. Maybe there's something being realized, something being brought to the surface, right? Because the Nyx, she dwells in a pond. Ponds are fairly shallow, so she's always on the surface of things. And whereas Melusina, she is a mermaid of the ocean, right? So behind her is this castle. And you know, I'm feeling really strongly that it's like you're letting your mind try to create that you need to escape something that you don't necessarily, but that's not the case. But it's the internal reflection, the time alone, the solitude, the stillness that's going to support you in seeing what is true. What else is here? Yeah, so, okay. This is about your self-worth, your self-value. Okay, this big queen energy again. You need to see yourself for who it is that you are. This could also have something to do with money. A lot of money is coming up here as well. You may have some communication with money coming through, perhaps in regards to you being you, right? Somebody may be seeing you, recognizing you, like people may be watching you in a sense, and seeing your worth, seeing your value. And this communication is coming through, and it may be shocking, right? It may make you see yourself. And through that, it's important that you take a moment to sit with it, to you know, recognize what is what, you know, because at the bottom here, we have a first house. And over on the tarot, we have the garden. So there's some cycle coming to an end in regards to who you project your energy outwardly as, or how you're viewing that, perhaps. What else is here? What do you see? That's the power. A lot of twos here, so it's like duality, balance, harmony trying to come through. It's important for you to, yeah, wow. All right, I've talked about duality and then can't really see this. Okay, this is the Four of Scarabs. So the Four of Scarabs is Mercury, Gemini, communication, the Lovers. So there's a lot of communication happening for you. That shock may be coming from an old relationship that may not be present at this time. There may have been some conflict within the relationship, and that's coming up to communicate the truth of something. You may have to be with that, sit with that, see what that means for you, right? Before you go and just take a response, go and respond. Granted, this can also be some communication in regards to work. This can be communication within your relationship as well, in how it is that you're gonna go, what direction you're gonna go into. This can also be speaking about a moving or coming in of new possessions as well. Something tangible here. And it's important that you don't get caught up thinking about it and like creating like whatever type of story that you feel you need to create surrounding it. Right, it's like you really want to know your worth and be very grounded and confident in that. So it's like, because the big queen is the second house as well. Right, and then we got this air energy with this Gemini and the Lovers and all these twos. It's a lot of earth and air energy. So earth and air create landfalls. they create, we can see tornadoes as earth and air, right? So I was talking about that with the weather and the tornadoes and everything like that. In regards to change, there's some change happening here. Some of a new flow, and this is by way of you truly seeing yourself, understanding and grasping the depth of who it is that you are. Okay, so we have the bride here. So a lot of this could be about, you know, relationship, but this is a lot about commitment and being committed to that. This is also about knowing that you have people around you that really support you, right? It's like a lot. When the bride comes up for me, it's like a lot of love. It's a lot of celebration. It's a lot of unconditionality, right? And longevity here. This is something that's like, okay, forever, but it may just be at the beginning, because this is the Page of Swords, right? And a marriage, granted, it's not the start of a relationship, but it is the start of forever of the relationship, right? This is beyond the courting stage, okay? This is commitment. This is all of that. So somebody may be getting proposed to with these second house, the bride and lover's card here. It's really important. It may be shocking. Like, oh my goodness, really? And it's important that you don't get too heady about it, but more so, you know, feel how you're feeling about it. Breathe into it. And it's a lot of nervous system energy here, right? So the sun is in Aries. Aries can have nervous tendencies. It can be very anxious and kind of like all over the place when it's no focus, right? So the commitment is so important. Maybe look up angel number 474. That may have something for you. 722-227 even. All right. What else is here? One last card for power. All right. Yeah, so things are definitely coming in for you. So it's time for you to surrender. This is Isis. In this deck, she's named Iset. I'll read it for you. She's in the Temple of High Priestess. And the bottom card is the Temple of High Priestess. Yeah, so it's like maybe you do spiritual work. Maybe you just really be in your spiritual bag often if you don't do spiritual work, but your work may be surrounded spirituality in some way. It could just even be like a caregiver kind of thing, because that work is very spiritual too. But she says, her guidance, we'll read this. She's revered as a magical healer and sorceress. She of 10,000 names, you may know her as Isis. Her Greek name are Iset was worshipped in ancient Nubia, the Sudan region, Egypt and beyond. Her guidance says, let it all go, say aloud now, I surrender. These words cast a spell, breathe them in. The embodiment says, release control, stop bonding around struggle, hand the keys to the divine, allow spirit to carry you and fill in the gaps. You don't have to figure it all out. God, Goddess has your back. Have faith in where you are at this moment. The declaration says, everything I need to know finds me at the perfect time. And so, okay, so when the card says bonding around struggle, so if you are like very committed, have this commitment to a connection or relationship, it's important for you to, what is the word I'm looking for, spirit? Can I have the words? Keep a watchful eye of the relationships it is that you have, that you hold, you know, so that they are not draining you, right? So if it's like a lot of this gossip, it's a lot of drama, right? Or maybe even you just have a lot of drama and gossip in your life, wherever that is within your personal life, just let it go. It's time to move on. Surrender to what it is that you need to do. Don't worry about the rest. Like, kind of, in a sense, let things be as they may, let people be who they are kind of energy, you know? So yes, by one. I hope this is helpful for you. I hope this supports you and gives you some guidance over on and through Aries season. All right. Maybe even look up the number 444 and see what that's giving for you. And yes, these are your messages, and I will see you very soon. Off to pile two. Well, what's up, pile two? So we're about to get into it. This is for you guys who chose the salt, Himalayan salt, rock heart. Okay, so some of you guys may be in a space of needing cleansing, right? It's maybe time for a cleansing of the heart, cleansing of old emotional relationship expressions, maybe cleansing in the way in which it is that you feel about yourself. Maybe this heart is sitting in the cauldron, so maybe you want to do a burning ball ritual of releasing any kind of bondage or ties, and it is that's not allowing you to really feel the love. Now, a berry season may just be filled with a lot of pure love for you that feels really good, really fresh, really new. You know, that is very flavorful in a sense, like has excitement to it, you know, really allowing you to experience life in a way that just feels good, right? Stay away from salty people, okay? And take care of not being salty yourself, okay? Because no one has time for that. So yeah, let's pull these cards and see what else is here. You may also want to maybe a time of connecting with family for you, okay? Earth, spirit, ancestors, guides, of those who chose God to. I ask that you come through and share any insight guidance that these lovely souls may need at this time. What messages do you have for them? What do they need to hear right now? Allow them to be a bridge, a conduit, and providing the messages that they need at this time. Okay, God, so let's see what's going down. Aries season for you. Okay. So it's definitely some decisions that need to be made. Right. And it's like a need to see things from a clear standpoint. Right. For there to be peace, for there to be solace. Right, because also your ancestors are trying to provide you with some messages that you may not be paying attention to because you may be caught up in this way or that way, right? But in reality, what is needed is transformation of you, focusing on the mastery, the mastering of yourself, okay? Because first we have the Two of Knives coming out here, right? So it's like, make sure that you are utilizing all your eyes to see things very clearly, right? Because it's necessary for you to let go of what has died. Whatever is old and done, it doesn't exist. It's not real like that. Not in the way in which that you may be holding on to. It's time to move on, literally, right? It's time to reconnect with your inner child, but also if you don't have an ancestor altar, if you don't practice any type of ancestral veneration, it's time for you to do so, because it's your ancestors who are going to support you in being able to connect with yourself in the deep way, in the depths of you that you need to. Right, so that you can work through whatever it is that has you confused, that has you in this space of not seeing things clearly. Like, it's three eyes missing, right? So we are said to have three eyes, our two eyes on our head and our third eye, right? So all three are gouged out. So with that, that's meaning to me, what I'm getting is that you are not putting any work in, not activating your energy toward your vision, toward what you see within your inner eye, right? Because those three together is about internal vision. It's not really about anything outside of you, right? Because what you're trying to do is focus on you, focus on your work, focus on your life, your family, your legacy. You know, that's where your focus is, right? And making that beautiful, making sure that you have everything it is that you need to take care of yourself, right? To whether that is the support, maybe you need to connect with some type of coach, or maybe you are the coach, you already have the information and you're just not utilizing it, and it's time to do so. And it seems that way because within the Eight of Coins and working on yourself, you come to this Bishop C.H. Mason. He is the Hierophant, right? So it's time for you to work your new program, right? You are, okay, so you are in two separate places because in your mind, it's like maybe your subconscious, it's a lot of cognitive dissonance going on here out of the fact that it's a need to release old programming to embrace the new one, right? So that you can come into this Hierophant energy, this Bishop C.H. Mason, right? And letting spirit lead you, guide you to the truth, to what is real, to what works for you, okay? But you do that by way of the mastering of the self. You keep your head down so that you can then look straight out ahead in front of you and see things very clearly, right? Because this work that you're doing for yourself, for your life, for your loved ones, this is it's like you're going through some sort of initiation here. What else is here, Spirit? It's definitely a lot of letting go and releasing karma. Old cycles. What are the messages? There may be something in regards to your health that you probably, whatever, if you are having any health issues, it's a mental thing. It's a mind thing. Right, your mind has got you in whatever work that is, and the change of the mind is going to help you start doing things differently so that you can get yourself back in alignment in the way that is pure. What else is here? It's definitely change happening here. What else is here for Aries season for child two? Okay, so first card you have out here is the Mermaid's Rock. She is this light. Let me see if I cut this down a little bit. If you can see the pictures a little better. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Okay, so the Mermaid's Rock. So she is a number 21. So this is about, again, this is about completion. It's about graduation. You are coming to this place. So it's like you perhaps, okay, Aries season just started. You a little confused. And you're like, I don't know. Then the second week, you're like, okay, I know what I need to do. I know what needs to change. Something comes to you and you put the work in. And then at the last week of Aries season, you have mastered this, right? And the Mermaid's Rock speaks about union. So it says, when two people in their hearts are one, they shatter the strength of stone. And let's see what she has to say. She says, your prayer will be answered. You strike upon what is eternally right for you and receive the finished stone you wish for. The Mermaid's Rock predicts your latent abilities, education, and a variety of refining will bring to life in you the holy and mysterious that creates solidity and cohesion. It represents an extension of the divine that is unchanging, solid, and external. Winning depends upon the inherent shift of the inherent shift in unshifting. I'm sorry, y'all. Winning depends upon the inherent strength and unshifting foundation of your faith. The mermaid rock signifies the lofty seats of the soul of the departed ancestors who, as a part of you, bring blessings and help. The link of love is eternal unless your heart has been turned to stone. Right. So for one, yes, this is about relationship union, but it's a lot about union of yourself, right? Union with your ancestors, because you are venturing into this space that is very true to you, right? Whether you are aware of what that is right now or not, right? But it's going to be your own personal tradition, your own personal doctrine, right? This is you creating the pages of your grimoire, you know, your book of shadows, however you want to put it, okay? But perhaps you want to learn something, perhaps you want to connect with a teacher. Even perhaps you are the teacher. A lot of this feels like that you are the teacher, not saying that you don't have a teacher, right? But at the end of the day, you are the teacher, and there are some things that are needing to be refined within you so that you can complete this cycle, so that you can graduate, so that you can enjoy your blessings that come with the work that has been put in you, the blessings that your ancestors have been attempting to bestow on you, that you may not have been paying attention to out of confusion. Okay, so whatever messages do we have here? Four, five, two. Yeah, so there is some cleansing, some purifying of the soul, of the heart that's trying to take place here for you. That is taking place, I should say. Yeah, because you come in, this is the second half of summer, I believe, but it's about savoring. So summertime may be very exciting for you, or you may just be feeling that summer energy through this spring by way of connecting with yourself, you know, right? Because you're taking action on what it is that you want, where it is that you want to go, you know, being very committed and consistent with that. This is a lot of prosperity here. Prosperity. And granted, it's not going to come without work, but it's going to be a good thing. Come on, cards and this. Pay attention to what you're eating. Make sure you do what you need to do, and that you are doing what you need to do in regards to the seeds that you're planting at this new moon that just passed. Pisces. What was that? Oh no, the new moon is coming up, the Aries new moon. So make sure you're putting in the work to the intentions you plan to set for this Aries new moon. Okay. What do we have here? Yep. So we have the Ace of Scarab. So this is the Fool, transformation, Scarab, and Kephra is life. And Scarabs are, you know, it's very earth energy. It's about destiny and fate and knowing that it's your responses that creates the secular, I think that's how you say it. Okay. Y'all know what I mean? Fashion of how things perpetuate in your life, right? So how they come to form. So you are on a new path, on a new journey. So what you're doing, what you're mastering, it's important to accept that it's not going to look like what you've just been doing, right? It's something much more lighter. It's something much, a lot more fun, that has a lot more joy and happiness in it. And whatever was, it didn't have this energy, you know? So it's important that you trust and have a lot of blind faith, faith of a mustard seed, okay? And moving forward so that you can, you know, just be unwavering in your approach to what you're doing. Be committed to you, at the end of the day, that's what this is about. What story are you writing? Be committed to that. What else is here? Spirit. What other messages do you have for the council? Oh, yeah. All right. You got the money safe here. So, like I said, it's a very prosperous time for you. Very abundant time for you. You may be in the space of creating wealth, even. You may be creating wealth with a partner, with this could be a friend, or this could be, you know, a marriage, even building something with your loved ones, your loved one. Okay. But money is coming to you. The safe is opening. And it's the enjoying of it that is going to allow you to really be on this new journey, this new path, this new flow in a way that feels good, right? It's like you got to get out of the space of two minds of how you're going to go about doing the thing. It's like things need to be linear for you right now. That focus has to be linear at this time. You are creating here. And wherever it is that you need to take a break, that you need to pause, make sure that you do that, right? So that you can see things very clearly, because 8 of coins is kind of like a pause energy. It's like I'm focused on myself, I'm focused on my work. It's about mastery. Yeah, so we have Queen Nandi, and she's about intuition. And so let's see, I believe she is in the temple of the high priest. Oh no, she's in the temple of queens. What am I talking about? Okay, so she is a Zulu queen, and her element is fire. Again, so that purifying aspect is here really strong when you got that summer energy, right? So although in the cards, there's no fire here. It is, the fire element is very present. It's very present and wants you to acknowledge that. It says Queen Nandi was the mother of warrior King Shaka Zulu. His father's royal family first rejected her. They said that she wasn't pregnant and her belly was resulted from an Ashaka beetle sting. But Nandi knew her son would be great before he was born. Her guiding says, you already know. Take a deep breath and surrender to what you know to be true and trust your inner wisdom and guidance. Her embodiment says, what is your guidance telling you? Put your hands over your third eye, center of your forehead, and ask, if I knew the answer, what the answer is, what would it be? And then follow your instinct. The creator and your ancestors connect with you through your intuition. Trust your internal GPS. The nudges, signs, and coincidences are divine guidance. Slow down, go for a walk, go for a walking meditation. Be present with nature and pay attention. Be present. Being present allows you to feel, hear, see, and sense your guidance. And her declaration says, I am knowing. Okay, so yes, how to. It's important that you know that you know. You know that you know. You know what you need to know. Whatever else you don't know, you learn it along the way. Okay, so maybe reading some books at this time would be good. Listening to some lectures, some podcasts, some maybe taking a small course or something that's going to help push you forward over to get you off the fence, right? So that you can go do you, all right? So that you can rise. Trust, you already know. We already be known. Just do it, okay? So pile 3, These are your messages. I hope that this blesses you. I hope this resonates for you. And I will see you very soon. Bye. Hey there, Pile 3. So this is for those of you who chose the moon. All right. So the messages I was getting with those of you who chose the moon, perhaps working with the moon will be very supportive of you. We have a Aries new moon coming up very soon in April. So maybe you want to focus on the intentions it is that you need to set at that time. But right now, as I'm recording this video, for this Aries season, the moon is, it's in its waning phase. I'm not sure what exactly phase it's in, but it may be important for you to focus on doing some releasing, doing some clearing. Maybe you need to do some editing for your life, focus on what needs to be changed, what needs to be let go of. Maybe you need to be working on finding forgiveness in regards to something even. Okay, there may be some stability that's needing to be had in regards to your mind, right? Maybe your mind might kind of be all over the place right now, in a sense, but it's important for you to connect with that and see what that is for you. What does that mean? You know, what is it? For real, what is it? You're also coming up out of some long cycles it is that you've been, maybe the cycles that you have been experiencing are present day kind of thing. They may be generated off of past life, but what I'm getting is it's more from a last year kind of thing. Probably this could be from Aries season of last year or perhaps Libra season of last year. So I don't know, I'll take a moment to see what you had going on during Libra season and Aries season last year. Okay, what was going down at the Aries full moon? What was going on with the Aries new moon? What did you culminate through that cycle? Okay, and where are you headed? Where are you going? What does that mean for you now? What did you learn? And how are you applying the wisdom of that knowing that you have at this time, okay, based off of that experience? So listen, what's going on, Spirit, for Pile 3? Your ancestors, guys, angels that walk with Pile 3, what messages, insights, and guidance do you have for them at this time? What advice that you have, please do share with them. Allow me to be a bridge, a conduit to share the messages and things that you have with Pile 3 at this time. Thank you. Going on, Pile 3. Oops. Pile 3. Okay. Yeah. So there's some delegation that's needing to happen. You need to be delegating. There's some balances needing to happen. First card that's coming out is the Ten of Sticks. So the first week of Aries season may be a little, you're seeing where the burdens are, where you, what's still carrying weight on you, what needs to be let go of, what is draining your youthfulness, your vigor. Okay. And you letting that shit go. Okay. Because following that, you have the Six of Coins. So with that, you are perhaps connecting with people who can help you with where it is that you're trying to get to in an easier fashion that is not burdensome. There may be something manifesting from you, for you even. It may seem like, oh, wow, I let that go and look at what happened. Right. Like, I didn't know I could do that. That's the vibes I'm getting for that. And with that, you're getting some much needed rest, like a break. And you're just like, all right, I don't need to worry. I don't need to concern with anything past of the past. I don't need to be focused on the future. Even I can be in this present moment and I can just be. my mind can be still, like thoughts gonna come up, but you don't have to attach to them. You don't have to relate them to something old and create a narrative around it and create this new trauma wound cycle thing going on, you know, and instead like freeing yourself and moving forward on your path, very strong, very courageous, right? There may be, it's like you've just taken a break from the adversity, whatever that adversity was, right? Because it really wasn't a thing that was, you know, sometimes we just be holding on to old stuff, okay? But it's in the letting that go, that what we are needing, what we want comes, that brings us that peace it is, that harmony, that balance that we want for our lives, okay? Some of y'all might be, maybe there's a relationship that's been burdening you. This could be like a marital relationship or something, and you are taking those problems off of your back. You're not worrying about it anymore. You may be gaining a new perspective in regards to it. You may be seeing the blessings, or you may just be leaving the relationship in general. But some of you may be having a new relationship coming through, right? So one that brings you peace of mind, that kind of, that supports you, that nurtures you, of what it is that you're doing, how it is that you express yourself. Like, it's like the stillness, this freeing yourself up from conflict, especially if that shit has to do with other people's opinions, okay? It's protecting you. It's bringing you some protection that you did not have once before, right? It's allowing you to be in a new space for real, okay? And in the old cycles, right? Just, it's time to relax. You're relaxing. That and over all three piles, that's what I'm getting for all three. Like, Aries season is putting us in a space where we can just relax. Like, look me in my face, I ain't got no worries kind of thing, you know? And it's definitely a new year. It's time for that. Time to let go of that which holds us back, that doesn't allow us to shine, that makes us feel like that we have to dim our light, that we have to dim our confidence, that, you know, because that is what brings us the harvest. That's where we reap. It's when we be ourselves, right? That's what Aries season is all about. It is about being yourself. It is sovereignty, all right? And we got Sagittarius here and Leo here. So we got all the fire signs here. Y'all the only pile that have all this fire. So whatever is ending, it's like completely, whatever you don't see right now, that you're not aware of, that needs to end, it's coming into your face and you're like, oh, that's that part, bye, kind of thing. And opening up to restoration, opening up to assistance, opening up, perhaps some of you are of service to others, working like the service field, however, this can be like a restaurant, maybe you work for a restaurant, maybe you're a chef, okay, or you could be like you serve service of like communication, some form of communication. Communication is vast, all right, so apply that where it may be. But you being confident is going to bring you the success it is that you are trying to achieve, that you are desiring to achieve through this, okay? What else is here today? What other messages do you have for pile three? What else would you like to put into knowing right now? Mm-hmm. Yes. It's really important for you to be focusing on your spiritual practice. That's going to help you release these burdens. Like, it needs to be an everyday thing, right? Because sixes are consistent. They're commitment. And strength is that as well for me. Like, it's a consistent thing. Four of Nines is like a meditative state, right? So you are receiving through stillness. You're receiving through releasing of the cycles of the moon. You really want to be paying attention to the cycles of the moon and how your life is showing up surrounding them. What is that looking like for you? Yeah, because you're coming into some greatness here. Something's coming back. Somebody coming back into your life. All right, so we have the gray whale. And the gray whale is about greatness. And it says, to give and receive genuine love brings gifts and happiness. Yeah, so it's like, focus on what is good. You know, focus on what is right. Focus on what makes you feel good. What makes you excited. Where is the joy? Where is the fulfillment and the happiness? You need to, this is a lot about connecting with your inner child here. The gray whale says, prepare a warm welcome and a clear coast. The gray whale that will swim up to humans and allow people to approach predicts that someone is curiously advancing. You may begin a new relationship project, change location, job, or course of education, creating a long-lasting effect and shaping your future for many years to come. You will go far in life, so push yourself. Nothing is beyond your expectations, since the migration of the gray whale is the greatest seen in any mammal. Any mammal, 25,000 miles from winter to summer ground and back. A holiday and travel abroad is forecast by it living along the coast, wallowing in just 2.5 feet of water. All right, look, you're going far. I don't know where you're going, but it's somewhere you ain't been before. And that's another thing that's been coming up. Everybody doing something new. And it's either been being in two minds of a thing, not seeing the worth, or worrying about somebody's opinions. Either way, everything gotta go that don't work for where you're going. You know, because it's important for you to do what it is that you need to do for yourself and have peace of mind in doing that, right? Not questioning that, not worried about what anybody else got to say, what anybody else thinks, because honestly, it just really doesn't matter. As much as we may think it matters, it doesn't, because once we go about doing it and living our life, no one can say anything, especially when there's greatness. Greatness brings success. Okay, so listen. And we just entering spring, you know, coming out of winter. So what you've been doing in this wintertime, come summer, it's going to be thriving. What have you been working through? What have you been working on? Where has your mind been? Have you been doing something, doing the work? Right, so it's like you're going to take a break through this Aries season for a minute. Like, maybe this abundance that's coming into you is going to let you be able to go into this meditative space, go into this reflective mode for you to come out and be a beast. I don't know, a beast of what? Let me know. I'm interested. I'm just nosy. Anyways, so we have the waning crescent moon here. So this is about y'all the first people to pull a moon card, all right? So, this moon energy is very prominent for you. It's really important for you to connect with those cycles of the moon. Maybe you want to have some rituals set around the cycles of the moon. Maybe you want to do some full moon, new moon, whatnot. All right. Get into it, because it's something that's neat, that's being released, right? That's what the waning crescent moon is about. It's about releasing. It's about reflection. It's about stillness. It's about internal things going on. So whatever is being let go is from within, right? So if this would have been like a waxing moon, then it would have been something you got going on materially, or something that you're doing, something that you're acting out that's needed to be released. But this is about within. This may be some type of emotion right? Remember I was talking about earlier, your feelings in regards to others, that may be a thing. Because at the bottom here of these mermaid cards, you have the return. So like somebody's coming back into your life and you may need to put your boundaries up in regards to that because of what it has to do with how you, what you think about their opinions, which you may not even know for sure if that's their opinions, because when Four of Knives come out after the Three of Knives, Three of Knives is like a heartbreak, a disappointment. It's also an awakening, right? But with this storyline that I'm half going on here, it's almost as if you've been holding on to that, right? And you're letting it go. And perhaps this is someone who is returning. I don't know. It could be someone of a fire sign. Could be a Sagittarius. Wow. There's a lot of Sagittarius energy here. Maybe you're a Sagittarius, you know, and that's coming through for you in some way. It could be a Capricorn as well. So those are signs to consider. Capricorn, Gemini, Sagittarius is what I'm getting with that. So let's see. What else do we have here? Maybe you're connecting with the Leo. Maybe the Leo connection is coming after releasing the old shit. The old things that don't mean you well. Really. Spirit is excited to give these messages to you. What else do they need to know, y'all? Pull a card. So you cannot see this at all. This is a Vasun sigil in between here. And this is the third eye. And the stone is lapis lazuli. So this is also, you cannot see this now. This is a seven of Ankh. So it's like a seven of sticks. Okay, so yeah, you may have been in the space of always feeling like you need to defend yourself, defend your vision, right? And in some regard, you may have stopped doing your vision, stopped acting on it by means of being really caught up in all the things, right? But beauty is here, all right? It's a beautiful time. You can see things very clearly. You trust your intuition, trust your insight. You know, you are clairvoyant. That it's possibly like your highest sense. You can see things for what it is that they truly are. You can see things that others may not necessarily be able to see, okay? So take that into consideration. Trust yourself. Maybe you want to get a lapis lazuli to wear. Maybe you want to get you some jewelry, you know, a necklace or something. Maybe you want to get you a ring. Maybe you want to sleep with it even. That would be good to help facilitate some dreams where you will, you know, consecrate it. Ask it to show you what you need to see in the astral, in your dream state. Let it be revealed to you. Yes, because it's all good. All right, this is the tree. Got strong roots, okay? A healthy home. Life is good. Money is coming. It's flowing, even. What it is that you have been desiring is coming as well. There's also a change. There may be a change in your health. Did I say something about, maybe that was the last reading. I talked about if there was some health things going on and maybe in your mind. But yeah, the sun is here in the back as well. So that's about vitality. And excuse me. Next niche. That's about vitality. You got some, you got a lot of security, comfort, and stability here with you. Okay. If you are worried about that, you need not be, because that is, if it's not here now, by the time Aries season is over, you will have that. Whether that is just simply within, okay. It's, did I tell y'all to be consistent? That is, it'll be a good idea to be consistent with your spiritual practice. Because I'm getting this here as well. Okay, maybe you are needing to get outdoors into nature too. It's springtime up here in the northern hemisphere. So getting out in the sun, making sure you're giving you some vitamin D, all right, and really taking care of yourself, being active. Pile three. It's really important for y'all to be active too. So spiritual practice and getting the blood moving, getting the body moving. What else is here? Letting things push through and flow through your body, letting them excrete themselves. Okay. With this release, is this waning moon? Maybe you want to do a cleansing. Evening, but like a nutrition-based cleanse, like a plant-based cleanse, like not no juice cleanse, but it needs to have, you're also coming out of self-sabotage, okay, because whatever you've been holding on to has been sabotaging you, but the cleanse that you want to do, you want it to have a lot of nutrients, right? So plant-based, a lot of nutrition in all of those things. Lots of like eating your colors, you know? And so the last card we have is Yasigi. She says, live out loud. It's time to do you, all right? And this is a number 31. And so that's Emperor energy. It's all about you. And she is in the temple of Griot. So this is Griot speak of actions that you need to take right now. Her element is water. So of the spirit, the soul, the emotions, Yasigi has a reputation of being a free-spirited party goddess. For the Dogon people of Mali, she was the very first Yasigi. Yasins are women empowered to participate in the mass dances. Her guidance says, express yourself. You have something to say. Share your voice in magic. Express your you-ness. Her embodiment says, the way you express yourself won't make everyone happy, and that's okay. You're not meant to. Living out loud and self-expression look different for everyone. For everyone. For outgoing extroverts, self expression may mean dancing on tables and screaming your points of view. Introverts may speak out in other ways and save the latter parts of their personalities for their loved ones. Goddess declaration says, I am free to express myself fully. So yes, y'all, my computer is about to die, pile three. I hope that blesses you. I hope these messages serve you, do you, in this Aries season. And I hope y'all have a wonderful, wonderful spring. The rest of the remaining of the spring readings will be up throughout the week, and I will see y'all very soon. Bye.